Come on, weatherman, give us a forecast, snowy white. Can't you hear the prayers of every childlike heart tonight? The Rockies are calling, Denver snow falling. Somebody said it's 4 feet deep. It doesn't matter, give me the laughter. I'm gonna choose to keep another tender Tennessee Christmas. The only Christmas for me, where the love circles around us like the gifts beneath our tree. Well, I know there's more snow up in Colorado than my roof will ever see. But a tender Tennessee Christmas is the only Christmas for me. Every now and there's a parade that we'd have it made that bring home a tan for New Year's Eve. It sure sounds exciting, awfully inviting. Still, I think I'm gonna keep another tender Tennessee Christmas. It's the only Christmas for me, where the love circles around us like the gills beneath our tree.
Okay, we're going to start off with a hunt we had earlier several days ago, and it was the annual Tennessee Trio Christmas hunt. But we had some people couldn't be here. Doug couldn't be here. Patrick Stewart couldn't be here. Donnie Vaughn couldn't be here. So Josh, I, and Jerry Watson, we carried the banner, didn't we, Josh?
We did.
All right. I know. I remember Jerry found this lighter part, and I know he found this, whatever, right. Josh, right? And a
lead.
Buffalo nickel and some lead and so forth. I don't remember what else he found. But anyway, a lot of Williams cleaner bullets and quite a bit of lead. Patrick makes these crosses made out of Civil War lead, so I'm sure he'll make good work of this. But we combined all our lead and going to send it to him. Josh dug this saddle shield, went on a McClellan saddle, and Jerry found the buffalo nickel, and so we had a good day. It was a lot cooler, a lot warmer than today, I'll tell you that.
Yes.
So anyway, we'll start our hunt for today here in just a minute. Well, it's a cold morning. What did you see on your truck thermometer on the way here, Josh?
About 17 degrees.
Yeah, it's nice. Just right for hunting. You're going to warm up, though.
Oh, yeah,
so Josh has been out here about 7-8 minutes. And what you got, Josh?
It's a Williams cleaner.
Oh, really? I'm surprised we found one here.
Yeah. It's a drop Williams cleaner,
Yeah, a lot of people don't realize that the Yankees had their factory-made bullets where the Confederates molded a lot of those. So, you know, you find this campfire lid, and we find a lot in here, and you say, well, why in the world did the, why did these, look up at me, Josh, why do you find these bullets like that? Well, there's wrapped in paper with a string around it at the end, went into the base of the bullet that wrapped around it, and during inclement weather, they would bite the end off of it, pour the powder on it, the wood to start a fire. So they didn't have no more powder, so what did they do, Josh?
Use them Williams cleaners.
Threw it away.
Yep, just threw it away.
Plus, they didn't like the Williams cleaners anyway. All right, back to it. Well, good morning again. This is Quindy. I just worked down in the camp probably 70, 80 yards from where Josh found the Williams cleaner, and I found one too. So we'll get back to it and see if we can dig something besides the Williams cleaners here. But it is still a lot of fun. It's beginning to warm up a little bit. See you in a few minutes. All right, few finds for me this morning. Got two Williams cleaners and a 58, drop 58 mixed right there, and a small, like a 31 caliber pistol bullet, a 44 Colt, the insert off a Williams cleaner, and a four-hole underwear button, and a few irons things in the pouch, but nothing really exciting in there. Okay. All right.
Heck yeah, Quinn, that ain't too bad right there.
Caught up with Josh. We've been hot about an hour or so. What you got, Josh? I know you had
got three
cleaners. I know that. What else you got?
This one's been fired, loaded and fired. See the ramrod?
Yeah, ramrod marks. That's right. Impressions.
Got some round balls, piece of round melted lead.
And you thought you had a Indian head penny, but it turned out to be what?
Memorial, yeah. And I got a case in there. I'm not sure what caliber it is, but it's rim fire. See where they fired it there on the rim.
Probably so. Could be a Merrill coming from this camp. We got
it had
cavalry here too. Okay, we'll get back with it. Thank you. Okay, Quindy and Josh again. This is what we found just today, and found a few Williams cleaner bullets, which you expect here. A few Colts. Josh found the Shield Nickel. We don't know what date it is yet, but it's somewhere between 1867 and what, 83?
1883, I think.
Yeah, I don't know if we can get a good picture of it or not, but it's got a big five on it. And Josh found a few coins, and these are, of course, World War II maneuvers. All right, Josh, talk about this piece, buddy. That's the find of the day, and it's not Civil War.
That was like a World War II, and the maneuvers were in here like an officer's or lieutenant's little bar.
Yeah.
You see the little clasp there. It would have had a little pin sticking out there with it. Clipped it on their uniform.
That's right. Now, I was with you, and you found a silver one and a gold one up in DeKalb County, and I think we figured out the silver one was a second lieutenant and the first lieutenant was a gold or something like that. I don't know. We're not
That's
military
a
people.
There, yeah.
So we had a good hunt today for the time we spent. It was real cold, warming up quite a bit now. We got a lot of campfire lead here for Patrick.
Oh, yeah.
So he'll be happy. He'll hug
there.
Your neck, Josh.
We got him a wad of lead.
Okay. So, yeah, had a very good day when you can dig this many relics. In a short period of time. So this is a file, I think we decided. But anyway, Josh, what do you want to say to everybody?
Hey, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Yeah, from the trio. So so have a good one. We'll be back hopefully sometime before the end of the year with another video. Check you later.
Heck yeah.